Hi, this is Munir Ajam, recording another video while I'm on assignments on the Caspian Sea in Turkmenistan, delivering training on cost, schedule, procurement, change management for clients. And as we go through the material, some of the questions that come up, and it came up in other workshops, is the question of competency and knowledge. And how do you develop people? And how do you develop competencies? Well, maybe first, this is definitely a deep question, and there are a lot of potential videos we could record on this topic. But let's start with the concept of knowledge. Knowledge is typically something we learn, what we know. We can say we have a knowledge of something. It could be the history, governments, or project management. And we can test people on if they have the knowledge, usually through tests, such as multiple choice questions. And an example of this in project management would be PMP or CAPM exam, which will be testing the knowledge. We know PMI claims that the PMP demonstrate competence, but let's leave it for another time. Competence is more of, I know something, and I know how to do it. So it's not only I have a knowledge of a topic or a subject, yeah, but I also can demonstrate that I can do it competently. An example of this. Someone can memorize probably in an exam that what is the definition of a float, total float or free float or project float. Demonstrating knowledge of what these words mean or these terms mean, that means you are demonstrating that you have the knowledge. You know what a float is, what a free float, what a total float, what a project float is. However, the question is, on a real project, yeah, do you know what's the difference between these floats and how are they used? And what does it mean? I mean, on a real project, what does it mean? Why do we care about free float, for example, versus float? Is there a benefit of one versus the other? If I need to work on a project and I want to delay an activity, what would I delay? If I have a problem with a project, again, how can I use these terms? And a competency, of course, I can sit down and interview someone. Then, okay, show me in this situation, what would you use? Similarly, let's say with scheduling, critical path analysis, someone can give me the definition of a critical path. That means they have the knowledge. Are they able to perform a critical path analysis on a good size project? Not something like we do for the exam with 6 or 7 activities. Show me. Can you demonstrate one? How does it work? Yeah? How do you use it on a real project? Again, that would be more of a competence. Same, obviously, I'm simplifying things a little bit. But in general, these are the concept here. So basically, knowledge is I know the information. Competence, I can do it competently, and I can prove I can do it. So this is usually competency. Now, how do we develop for competency? And this is a question that came up from the project engineer I've been working with all weeks. Yeah, and one time in the past, somebody came and gave them an assessment, and they bid it on the PMBOK. Well, that was the first thing that was a mistake. PMBOK is not enough. These guys work in oil and gas. They have things that they work on project and life cycles and phases that are never mentioned in the PMBOK. So how could you assess them based on, oh, do you know how to create WBS? Okay, yeah, I know how to create WBS. Then, okay, how many WBS would I have on the job? Who is responsible for doing WBS on the job? And these other questions. So basically, to develop competence, and usually it require on-the-job training. So having classroom training is not enough. I can teach people on how to create WBS, do schedule, develop estimate. But unless they are giving the opportunity to sit down on project, on a real project, and develop an estimate, how can they demonstrate to me that they are competent in estimating? Unless they can come and do a quality plan, how can they demonstrate competence that they are able to do quality plan? This is why, for example, we always advise organization. Training is good. Classroom is good. Yeah, but if you want to train and develop your talents, or develop the talent of your people, and to have them to become competent and capable personnel, you have to focus on, basically, you have to focus on them being able to be given on the job opportunity where they have to practice what they learn in the classroom. So it's very important in these cases to blend classroom training or classroom session with on the job assignment, with mentoring and coaching, and they will be should be given the opportunity to demonstrate these things. Now, of course, with competence, we cannot expect people to be expert quickly. So usually we scale people and we might score them and we might give them different score. And basically, for example, we can use the scoring on 1 to 5 and say, okay, 1, this person is aware. For example, if let me go back to scheduling. Said, okay, can you explain to me scheduling? You have the knowledge. Okay. Or awareness, maybe that's a 1. Do you have knowledge of scheduling and you know how to do schedule? That may be a 2. You can demonstrate your ability to do a schedule, basic schedule. That may be a 3. You can demonstrate ability to perform a complex schedule. That may be a 4. You're an expert in scheduling. That may be a 5. So, competency in that case, again, I'm using, there are a lot of models out on the word, and I'm just going to using a simplified model here, a question, is basically the ability to have the people go up, not go up the rank, but basically go up in their knowledge and experience and competence. And to develop this level, obviously, we have people, this have to be given the opportunity. So talent development, competency development require the skills, require the ability to learn, to have the knowledge, to have the information, and to be able to practice it and work it on real project, on real life environment. Okay, usually under, obviously for fresh or a new learning, we need, ideally it would be great to have a coach or a mentor supporting us. Thank you, and have a great evening.